Hi everybody, I am Prof. Nurul Amin from Bangladesh with lots and lots of greetings. We are very happy and delighted to know that Andheri Health Vibhon, a philanthropic organization of Germany, is going to celebrate its 50th anniversary along with the 90th birthday of its founder president Ms. Rosie Goldman on 10th of June 2017. We as a partner feel part of these celebrations. We wholeheartedly congratulate Andheri Health Vibhon for its 50 years of successful humanitarian service and wish a very happy 90th glorious birthday to Ms. Rosie Goldman, who has sacrificed her whole life to bring happiness to suffering humanity. With all good intentions to attend the celebration, I could not join due to personal difficulty. So I have decided to be with you by narrating the story of partnership between Society for Assistance to Hearing Impaired Children, SAHIC of Bangladesh, and Andheri Health Vibhon. In creating the facilities for prevention, early detection, treatment and rehabilitation of hearing impaired, especially children, in the absence of which many were becoming disabled to live a miserable life. As an ENT specialist practicing in Bangladesh, I had to see a lot of hearing impaired people, especially children with hearing disability, but could not be of any help to them due to non-availability of facilities in the country. It gave me a lot of pains, so I was thinking to do something for them. United Nations declared hearing impairment as a cause of human disability, requesting member countries to take appropriate measures to avoid their disability in the General Assembly of 1986. Inspired by this resolution, I, along with some of my like-minded friends and social workers, formed Society for Assistance to Hearing Impaired Children, SAHIC, and got the permission of the government to function as an NGO in 1989. SAHIC started its activity by organizing mobile ear camps in the remote villages of the country with ENT specialists to treat minor conditions causing hearing impairment and to create public awareness about hearing impairment and its disastrous effect on human life, families and the society. It got tremendous response from local people to get help. It became evident from the experience of ear camps that to give effective help to majority of the patients, a center with advanced facilities to diagnose and treat is essential. Accordingly, SAHIC took a decision to establish a center of excellence, but finance became the biggest obstacle to proceed. My relationship with Ms. Rosie Goldman and Andheri Health Vibhon developed through working together in the prevention of blindness program of BNSB Chittagong in partnership with Andheri Health Vibhon during 1973 to 1983. When I was an active member of the executive committee of BNSB Chittagong. I got transferred to Dhaka as a part of my job in 1982. And while at Dhaka, had to look after the delegates from Germany on their way to Chittagong and back. During this transit, I invited Ms. Rosie Goldman to attend few year camps SAHIC organized, which she gladly accepted and got impressed with the enthusiasm shown by the people to get the help from the ear camps. With the hope to get financial support for the center, we approached different quarters without much response. Taking the advantage of our friendship, love, affection and kindness of Ms. Rosie Goldman towards disabled, especially children, I took the courage to approach her if Andheri Health Vibhon could be of help to undertake the project. She accepted to support the center provided the land is given locally. We approached the Ministry of Health, Government of the People's Republic of Bangladesh, who were implementing the various WHO programs, referring the UN resolution taken in the General Assembly in the year 1986 about hearing impairment to provide a plot of land, and the Ministry was kind enough to donate a plot of land in its Mohakali Health Complex at Dhaka in 1990. To implement the project with the financial support of Andheri Health Vibhon. Starting the construction of the center in January 1991, completed and inaugurated to function in February 1992 with the facilities to see 100 to 150 patients and to do 40 to 50 tests in a day. The reputation of the center spread very fast and started drawing ever increasing number of patients day by day, with increased number of tests needs to be done. Till December 2016, about 1.5 million patients are seen in the center, and about 0.4 million different hearing tests are performed, with about 12,500 hearing aids are fitted to the needy patients. To accommodate the ever increasing number of patients, the center had to be expanded by shifting the office block and hearing testing laboratory from ground floor to the second floor of the center in 2013. Now, to be able to see 400 to 450 patients and 100 to 120 tests to be performed in a day. To provide a special education to the congenitally hearing impaired children without development of speech, with the help of hearing aids, a preschool with capacity of 160 children was built with the financial support of Andheri Helpi in the same campus and started functioning from October 1994. Till December 2016, about 4,500 hearing impaired children received a special education in the school, making them enabled to join primary schools of the country to study with normal hearing children of the same age. With the increasing number of children, the school building had to be expanded during 2008, now accommodating 300 children. To prevent hearing impairment and to restore and reinstate lost hearing by surgical intervention, a 28-bedded specialized ENT hospital was built with a modern operation theater block on the first floor of the center building in July 1999. 50% cost of the hospital was borne by Andheri Helpi. Till December 2016, about 46,693 patients were operated, of which 18,777 were microsurgeries of the year, along with 21 cochlear implants. To disseminate the facilities to other part of the country, a subcenter was built in 1999 at Pahartoli, Chittagong, with an outpatient department, a hearing testing laboratory, an ear mold laboratory, and an integrated preschool for 60 hearing impaired children. We are very happy to inform you that Andheri Helpi not only supported the construction and equipment cost of the center and the preschool at Dhaka, but also bear the running cost of the center and the school for 8 years from the date of inauguration. It may be also mentioned here that the center got the responsibility to run the WHO program Prevention of Deafness in Bangladesh for 8 years, to train the primary healthcare workers in collaboration with the government. We are most grateful to the members of Andheri Helpi board, the government of Germany and people of Germany in general, and Ms. Rosie Goldman, a kind-hearted, generous lady in particular, for the unprecedented support to create most needed facilities for hearing impaired of Bangladesh, especially children, with establishment of National Center for Hearing and Speech at Dhaka, which has been described by Professor P.W. Alberti, the then Secretary General of IFOS, as an oasis in the sea of need in Bangladesh during his visit to Bangladesh. The activities of SAHIC now are run by an elected committee and myself as the honorary director and the founder advisor. Financing of the project are met from nominal fees taken from the patients, generous donation by local philanthropic persons and organizations, and annual government grants. SAHIC allows free treatment to the destitute, subsidy to the poor from 30% to 90% depending on their socioeconomic conditions, and charges the actual cost of treatment from the able people. I wish to recollect some of our friends and well-wishers from Germany whose wisdom, knowledge and donations helped us a lot. we shall always remember them for their kindness, love and affection towards the hearing impaired of Bangladesh. The names are late Father Martin, late Maria Walraff, late Professor Armin Lua, Professor Ninhas, Mrs. Eliza Schmidt, and many others whose name I could not recollect at this moment. I wish to conclude by congratulating Andheri Helfi and Ms. Rosie Goldman again for the wonderful humanitarian service they are doing around the world, especially in Bangladesh. We pray for the continued success of Andheri Helfi and a very happy, peaceful, long life of Ms. Rosie Goldman. At the end, I thank you all attending the ceremony and bond.